Yes, hello students. So today here also we are going to do the some numerical problems related with the DC machines. So if you look at the third problem, which is related with the DC shunt generator. So this is one kind of problem which deals with the losses. So let's look at the third one. So a DC shunt generator delivers 45 ampere at a terminal voltage of 220 volts. The armature resistance is given by 0.01 ohms and shunt resistance 44 ohms and the stray losses are 375 watts. Then find out that efficiency, percentage of efficiency of DC shunt generator. This is the problem he asked. So let me repeat once again. A DC shunt generator delivers 45 amperes at a terminal voltage of 220 and the terminal voltage is given 220 and the armature resistance is 0.01 ohms and shunt resistance 44 ohms and the stray losses are given 375 and he asked that percentage efficiency of DC shunt generator.
You are now unmuted.
So let's solve the problem. So here is the solution. What type of machine it is? DC shunt generator, not series. Let's solve the problem. Yeah, so first of all write the given datum. What the type of machine it is? Type of machine, type of machine is DC shunt generator. DC shunt generator. Okay, so now the remaining things as we have given the numerical, the generator delivers 45 ampere, which delivering 45 amperes means what? That is a load current. Load current in the numerical he never give you is that a load current or armature current. You need to understand which is a load current. Load current which is given 45 amperes. Guys, next, the terminal voltage is given. The terminal voltage VT, that is equals 220 volts. Okay, and the armature resistance is given. Armature resistance is given RA is equals 0.01 ohms and shunt resistance is given RSH and 44 ohms and stray losses are given. Stray losses are given around 375 watts. Losses always measured in watts, okay, not in volts or amperes, right? And he's asking to find out that efficiency. Okay, this is very interesting problem, guys. Very, very interesting one. So first of all, you need to write that efficiency formula. Okay, so as we know that efficiency, so the neta for a DC shunt generator or any generator, we have to write output by input into 100. If you want to get the value in terms of percentage, you need to multiply with the 100. But the input of the generator is mechanical, right? Output of the generator is electrical. So it is better to write in terms of output. It is better to write power output plus losses here. Right? Is it clear? So power output divided by the power output plus losses, so that we can calculate easily, because the output of the generator is electrical, right? So that I have taken that output instead of the input with the help of losses. Now in the numerical, the data, just look at that. So stray losses are around 375 watts given. Okay, 375 watts, and in addition with this, armature resistance is a 0.01 ohm. So So you need to find out whether generated EMF first, right? So EG is required. EG is required. Why we need the EG value? Because the EG is nothing but the generated induced EMF of the generator. So that first of all you need to find out that EG value. Whether it is useful or not, you need to find out first. So V plus IA RA. IA RA. So what are the values we have? 220 plus 220 plus. Do you know the value of armature current? You don't know. And what will be the value of armature resistance? That is a 0.1. Yes, this is a EG. But in this equation we don't know the value of armature current, right? So let's calculate that armature current also. So this is the DC shunt generator, right? So I'm drawing one circuit, DC shunt generator, so that we can understand that this is the load. This is a shunt generator, right? So this will be the RSH and this will be the armature resistance and this will be the generator, right? So now from this I am going to write the armature current value. So that is equal to IL plus ISH. Again here we don't know the value of ISH, so we have one formula, that is ISH is equals to V by RSH. Now you can substitute the values of voltage 220 by RSH value is a 44 ohms, and the value will be 5 ampere here. Now you can substitute here 5 ampere. So the load current, how much load current is given? 45 amperes. And the shunt current, that is 50. So total value will be the 50 ampere. Okay, now you can substitute value in case of equation 1. Okay, apart from that we will substitute later. Let's go through that losses. So stray losses are around 375, right? Stray losses are given 370. Let's find out that output power first. Output power, P output. So V into I, right? So load current we know. So 220 into load current, that is 45 ampere. So that how much you will get? 9900 watts. Okay, this is 9900 ma. Okay, so now whereas coming to losses, we need to add the total losses. You need to add the total losses. Stray losses are given, but we don't know the shunt field copper loss and armature copper loss, right? So you need to find out shunt copper loss, and I'm highlighting this shunt field copper loss because it is a DC shunt generator. Shunt field copper loss. So shunt means ISH will be there and RSH will be there, right? So well and good, just substitute the value. ISH is the 5 square and RSH, how much it is given? 44 square. How much you will get? You will get around 1100 watts. So in the same manner, you need to find out that armature copper loss. Armature field copper loss. Okay. Armature copper loss. So the same procedure, IA square, RA square. So IA value how much? 50 ampere. So 50 whole square into armature resistance. It is given 0.01 whole square. If you calculate this, you will get 25 watts. Okay, now from these losses, we got the losses which represents the losses, which represents losses, which is equals to stray losses plus shunt field copper loss. Okay, so I am writing PSH copper loss. Next, armature copper loss, PCU at armature. Okay, now substitute all the values. The stray losses is given 375 and shunt field copper loss we got 1100 watts, and armature copper loss is given 25 watts. So how much it is? 375 plus 25, okay, 380 and 400 plus that 1100, total how much? 1500 watts. This is about the total loss. Now you can substitute directly. You can substitute directly the value in the equation efficiency. So how much is the P output value? 9900 divided by how much? 9900 plus losses 1500 watts. If you want to calculate in percentage, just multiply with the 100, so it will become percentage of eta. Now the value will be 86.54%. This is the efficiency of DC shunt generator. This is the efficiency of DC shunt generator, 86.54. So this is the efficiency. This is the procedure to find out that efficiency of any electrical machine. Okay, especially for the DC generator, this is the procedure ma. I hope it is very clear. You need to find out the total losses first. Stray losses only given in the numerical, only he given stray losses. Okay, so no need to find out the stray losses. So just you need to find out the shunt field copper loss and armature copper loss. Okay, and directive formulas, we know that I square R, any loss that can be found out by using the P is equals to I square R. So if it is a shunt field, ISH square into RSH. If it is a armature copper, then IA square into RA square. And at the end, you need to add up the total losses. So from this, you can add the losses here, right? And you need to substitute in the efficiency equation. Okay, so I hope it is very clear. Thank you guys. Thank you.